All right, so we're off on another adventure. We're headed down on this really cool motorcycle trail. Got the entire family and the dog. All right, here we go.
All right, here we go. Max literally goes everywhere we go. And we generally always pack a 22. There's been a bunch of different bear sightings up here. Not that I'm afraid of them, but it's always nice just to have a little extra something just in case, you never know. And that's our little 170 steel chainsaw that we pack everywhere.
It's pretty bumpy.
Yeah.
Wyatt, you got your gun? We're not. Just another family adventure. Mosquito. Sitting in the back. Nothing like a Honda, you guys.
Yeah.
Making our way up on this killer trail. We're so excited about getting this cedar. And the boys love this. Keep going, you're good. Hold on, this is great footage. No, you're okay. No, keep turning, it'll turn. We're gonna bounce this trailer right off this. Here we go. There you go. All right, so we're gonna go to the end of this trail, turn around, but this is what we're after, you guys. So this cedar tree is probably, I don't know, at least 150 years old. And what's amazing, this has been laying out here in the woods for, I don't know, probably 40, 50 years or longer. And look, it's still good. This is the best kind of cedar you can get. This is, you can make cedar planks out of it, and we use it for cedar kindling to start our fire. But look at that, how it dries out. That's amazing that, yeah, it's absolutely amazing that these cedar trees can lay here like that and still be good quality. Yeah, look at that. It's all side dug out. All right, so we've come to the end of the trail. Our neighbor's gonna continue on up onto his piece of property that he owns. We're gonna spin everything around, we're gonna head back, and then we're gonna load up that cedar. We wanted everything empty so that way it wouldn't be so hard. So we're gonna go ahead and break this down, lift this up. These little John Deere trailers, you guys, I don't think this thing weighs but 50 pounds. I mean, 100 pounds max.
and it'll actually haul a lot of weight. They are rough, so you go real slow. There's no suspension, but look how maneuverable these things are back in on these trails. So we'll just kind of slide that out of the way.
These boys can hit stuff with sticks for hours.
I got this one.
Oh, good job.
You guys, this boiler here is a Rubicon 500, fuel injected.
And you know his chainsaw?
Yep, we got our chainsaw. Honda's not the fastest, you guys, but they are bulletproof. This bike here has over 6,000 miles on it, and all we've done is changed oil and an air filter. They're bulletproof, I swear, by Honda. Just like that, we're ready to go. These little trailers are dynamite.
Yep.
All right, so we're down here. We got these cedar logs. Here's a big round we're gonna cut. I don't have my big chainsaw. My brother-in-law has got it borrowed. I have a chainsaw milling for it, and he was cutting up some rounds. So I said, hey, just take my chainsaw. And of course, now I need my big saw. But we're gonna do what we can with this little saw and show you that they're actually pretty cool little saws. They can just about do anything. Could. There's definitely a little bit of rot on here, and so we brought the axe, and we're just gonna trim up all the worms here. You can see bugs in it. You know, you don't want that inside your barn because you don't want the bugs in your lumber of the barn. So we're just gonna trim it up and get just the primo. All right, there you guys go. Finished product.
Oh, it's beautiful.
It smells amazing.
Oh, yum. Yeah, bud. Ooh. Ooh, you found an old stump? Did you find any bugs in it?
Got it. Boy, look at that.
Ah,
I mean, that is like premium cedar.
You smells good, too.
You don't even get this kind of cedar anymore, you guys. See how easy it splits? And see how the grain, there's no knots. This is what old growth cedar is all about. There's no knots. It's just a smooth piece of lumber. When I was a kid, I don't know, I couldn't have been very old, like 7, 6. But I remember my dad going up on BLM and cutting huge rounds out. He had a permit, of course. And he would roll them over a canyon, like 300 yards. And he'd load them up in trucks. And he would make cedar shakes out of it for extra money. But yeah, I remember that as a kid. And here I am out here with my wife and my two boys. You know, we're not doing the same thing, but pretty close. And it's really fun.
That's awesome.
Chop out that rotten stuff. And look at that.
How nice.
That's like, I'm sure this tree is 100 years old. Plus the
yeah.
Here. Look at that. Oh my God.
Fabulous.
Mm.
Look at that. It's already making a piece of kindling for you.
Yeah. There's like zero bugs in this, you guys.
Hey.
That other tree that we first started on had so much bugs in it. We're like, you know what? Let's just go back and we'll get this. And yeah. We're pretty fortunate our neighbor lets us come out here and grab this beautiful cedar.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Making sure we don't bring any bugs to the barn.
You helping out, Wyatt? All right.
All right, we're coming off the trail. We got our cedar. Just barely can see it. Wyatt, can you give a nice smile? There you go. All right, here we go. Yeah, we took this opportunity to pick some fresh flowers for beautiful. We know how our ladies love to have fresh flowers, especially coming from our men. All right, show Mama your flowers.
Oh, look at that big, beautiful bouquet. Thank you, sweetie.
Oh,
they have the sweetest boys in the world. So sweet.
All right, we made it home, and now we're just going to stack this in our barn for, you know, whenever we need to build a fire for our wood stove for our house.
Oh, look at my big helpers. All right, put it in the wood pile. Woohoo! All right, well, they're stacking that kindling. Oh, I was gonna check the eggs. She didn't lay yet. You'll check later.
All right, you guys, thank you so much for joining in, watching us go out there and get our kindling for next year's firewood. And, you know, coming up episodes, we're gonna be out tuna fishing. So we'll be, you know, 40 miles out in the ocean in our boat. We're gonna be doing bottom fishing, and we have salmon season coming up. So a lot more videos coming, you guys. So like and subscribe, don't miss out. And thank you so much for joining in with us.
Woo, see you later.
See you later. What have you done? What you want?